Some people call them UCura 3 supports. Others, Prusaslicer's organic supports. I call them Thomas Furs, by the author of the remix. Original 3 supports were made by Cura team. And if you ever wondered how easy they are to remove, today you'll know more than you ever wanted to. The thing in my hand is Plumber's nightmare, but Dave makes stuff. And brilliant stuff at that. A challenge model that absolutely requires dissoluble supports. Or does it? Of course, for now, you'll have to believe me that this disturbingly shaped blob of purple PTG is said model. It's down there, I promise. And we are going to liberate it. Of course, I'm so sure of it because I've done that already and live to tell the tale and also to write and record this video script. Here are tools of the trade. Not this. Don't try to use clippers as a crowbar. I know you want to. You can tell I never done that, as my clippers are still intact. I actually ordered these sculpting tools and these sharp cutting tools, specifically for support removal, and we'll use them later in the video, but not for support removal. Because we'll only use this. You can tell I've been using them, can't you? But seriously, the only tool we really need is round tip pliers. They are truly amazing, and I rarely resort to anything else. This and the sink with warm water to soften the plastic. This is the hardest model to remove supports from, where it's still quite possible. I'll show you in the end how to set the supports in the slicer, so they don't grow through the whole model. But now, let's get rid of them. Despite being only one wall thick and empty inside, trunks are rather thick at the base, so it's pointless to start with them. I squeeze smaller tips of the branches, roll the pliers away to separate supports from the model. The rolling motion is the trick. You grab thinner and weaker parts, wrench them from the model with rolling motion, and then repeat and repeat some more. With PETG like mine, you'll have to roll more, but the branches are easier to hold and compress than with PLA. Eventually, you'll be able to get to thicker branches, and then to the trunk. I can guarantee you that any support removal you realistically perform will be magnitudes faster and easier too. I was worried about inner supports, but they were actually much easier than the outer ones, and I didn't deform any tube there. While the model looks rather good and works as designed, I've damaged 4 tubes with my support removal. I suspect I've been tagging the wrong part, as telling the supports from tubes is rather difficult at the start. Keep in mind that I printed the model at half scale to save on plastic and to print faster. At that time, I fully expected it to never work. Waste-wise, 3 supports are rather efficient, but for this model there is no way around it. It needs a lot of support. I can't possibly risk filming myself operating a heat gun, but I did hit the model with it and used sculpting tools to repair damaged tubes. I also cut away all the blobs and imperfections with those scalpels that are safer to use off-camera. So does it work? Let me choose one long tube, this one, and push some colored liquid inside. Works like a charm. The only tube that doesn't work is this one at the bottom. Should have checked the preview more carefully. This brings us to slicing. There are a lot of settings there, and of course, you are free to use mine. For this particular model to work, I was advised by Thomas himself to lower the support angle. At 50 degrees, the branches still enter horizontal parts of the tubes, but they don't reach far, and can be easily removed from there. The block bottom tube should be easier to clean with the support blocker. Sounds logical, right? I wish easier 3 support removal to you all, and one that leaves your models intact. that it 3D prints and leaves, and there will be more both 3D printing and leaves in the future. See you then!